say that I'm sorry for not getting back to you after, well, not after, but before the surgery. Like I said, I would, but I am back. It's actually 6 days after the surgery is performed. Tomorrow's actually going to be a whole month. So I'm actually kind of excited about that. And I'm just going to give you a rundown of what happened. I actually have it on a sheet of paper right here that I'm going by, just to let you know about everything I've gone through as far as the laparoscopy. Yeah. I know if I was still sitting around, but yeah. So I had to be there at 5 o'clock that morning. The first, the day of the surgery actually was on July the 19th of 2017, this year, last week, yeah. I had to be there at 5 o'clock in the morning, and I actually didn't get into my room, well, not my room, but like the little, kind of, not an emergency room, but kind of like the same-day surgery room where you go in. You're expected to have same-day surgery. But yeah, I got that room around 6:10 that morning, so like it was an hour and 10 minutes that I waited after the doctor. And actually before then I had to try to get business such as pain stuff because I didn't meet my deductible yet. I rarely get sick, so I hadn't met my deductible. So I had to go and pay and all that. That probably took like 15 minutes. You have to go and make sure to sign in, get my wristband and all that. And then get to my room until like 6:10. Now I had my pre-op talk / Q&A, which is where they come in and tell you about what's going to happen with the surgery. Ask questions about your past health history, basically. And that happened around 6:45. And then like about 30 minutes later, there were two other nurses that came in to actually prep me for the operation. They had to prep me by shaving, getting my IV fluid started, getting my leg massages on. And the leg massages are used so that you don't develop blood clots after the surgery. And they had to prep and shave me, and they had to shave your abdominal area since that's where the incisions are going to be. And they also, please don't get grossed out, but I think it's mostly going to be women watching this anyway. But they had to shave your lady parts. I'm going to say that. They're going to shave your lady parts. And the reason why is because they're going to be using a catheter. Most of the time they use a catheter in my case. So they had to shave it down so that there would be no risk of bacteria, no hair growing in there, and all that. So, and then around 8, I got transferred to the holding room, and that's basically your next step after you get to your preliminary room, you get talked to, get prepped, and all that. And then you go to your holding room, which is the last place you go before surgery. And the anesthesiologist came like an hour and 45 minutes later, around 9:45. And she basically came and told me how to go and administer anesthesia and what you're going to do at the surgery again. So I had a great understanding how the surgery was going to go, what was going to happen, and all that. I felt a little bit more confident. Now, I think I stayed there like almost 6 hours, something like that. I'm probably off with my time. I got wheeled away to go to the operating room around 2:10. And they didn't actually start surgery until like 3:10, so like an hour later. And I'm guessing that's from them having to give me shots and stuff, getting positioned and everything. Make sure that I was properly prepped. And get me hooked up to monitors too, because when I woke up, there was monitors and sticky stuff all over me. So they had to do all that within an hour or whatnot. And actually, the way it worked is when they were getting ready to wheel me out, there was this nurse man. And he put something in my IV. I asked him, I said, what is this you put in my IV? And he said it's something to calm you down. But little did I know, that's extra stuff to start putting me to sleep. And the reason I know that is because the last thing I remember before falling asleep was I was getting ready to ask them a question about some of the machines in the room. I was so fascinated with the machines and stuff. And I was about to ask a question about the machines. And I didn't even get to ask my question because I was asleep. But I woke up around like 5:50, almost 6, in the recovery room. Nurse was trying to wake me up and stuff. You know, I was actually halfway awake, but I wasn't sure. I was kind of like, you know how when you're woke, but then you think you're asleep. I don't know if you felt that before, but that's what I was. I thought I was asleep, but I was actually woke. So, yeah. I got wheeled away to my actual room because I actually stayed one night. Just one night. And I got wheeled away to my room around 6:10-ish. And then I actually ate my first meal, because remember in the last one I told you I couldn't eat anything after midnight, eat or drink anything after midnight. So, I actually, my first meal after the surgery was chicken broth, jello, and water. And that was the best dang thing I could have had. I thought it was, so bad, I'm hungry. So, yeah, I ate that. And then I fell asleep around 10:30. My mom actually stayed with me. My honey bun, which you're going to see him in the next video, because he's been cooking for me. I can't cook right now after the surgery for like 2 weeks, which I'm about to enjoy the heck out of these 2 weeks. Well, a week now, since basically this other week is gone. But I'm going to enjoy the heck out of this. So, yeah. So, where was I? Oh yeah, okay, so he had left or whatever, and my mom stayed the night with me up there at the hospital. Now I'm gonna tell you some of the things I felt after the surgery. Yeah, I did have some, probably like moderate gas pains, which is in my abdominal area, and that comes from them. When they do the operation or surgery, they actually have to put gas into you to actually, I don't know a nice way to say it, but to blow you up or to expand you so that they can actually see. Because with the laparoscopy, you know what I'm trying to say. With the laparoscopy, they had to make the incisions and put the little laser with the camera on the end, on the inside of you so that they can see what's going on. And mine was actually a diagnostic laparoscopy. So, yeah, anyways. So since they had to put a laparoscope, that's what it's called, a laparoscope. Since they had to put a laparoscope inside of me, they had to actually be able to see, right? So they had to expand my abdominal area by putting gas in me. I think maybe carbon dioxide, I think that's what it is. They put carbon dioxide inside of me in order to expand me so that they can see what's going on. So they can see where they're going, what they're doing, and all of that. So that's where the gas pain came from, because of course all the gas is not going to go away like that. And I also woke up with a sore throat. Now, I really didn't feel it until like the next day, and it was horrible. But yeah. Now that first night at the hospital, I woke up 4 times, and that was because the IV thing kept beeping. And the nurse said that it was air. It was telling her that it was air in the IV. And so we end up getting that changed out so it could quit beeping so I can get me a little bit of sleep. Now, I woke up 1 time for pain, and it was because the gas pain was actually starting to get severe. And the anesthesia, I guess, was wearing off a little bit. I could feel a little bit more. And also, the wonderful leg massage started. I loved it. So basically, the leg massage I was telling you about earlier, and the prep and shave and stuff, basically they put it on your legs, like all the way from your knee all the way to your ankles. And once I got in my room for the night, they cut the baby's on, and it felt so good. And I wish I had a man massage my legs. Free leg massage. Well, no, it wasn't free because I had to pay for it. But anyway, that's it. Okay, and then, so, that was actually the day of the surgery. That's the end of my day of the surgery. So now I'm going to go to the next day when it was actually time for me to get ready to go home. Now, the first thing they did, they came and removed my catheter. I'm going to tell you about this catheter. Now, if I was awake and they put this on, I'd probably be hurting very bad. I probably wouldn't even let it happen, but I think it's a good thing they put it on while I was asleep. But once I woke up or whatever, the day before, which was on the 19th, I didn't realize I had a catheter to me until I had to go use the restroom. I felt my bladder fill up and whatnot. And I asked the nurse, I said, can I go to the restroom? And I said, how do I go to the restroom? Because I have to go. And she said, you just go. And I said, am I going to be peeing on myself? She said, no. She said, you have a catheter. It's right there. And actually, they had the little tube up me. And they had the little container collecting my urine and whatnot. Anyway, first thing the next morning, they removed it. I was actually loving it because I could just sit there, watch TV, and just pee away. Don't call me next. I enjoyed that. But I know I have to actually get that out of me so I can resume my normal restroom using pattern. But I was enjoying it. I was being lazy. I was enjoying that. So once that was removed and whatnot, then they came and I got some breakfast. And I actually was able to get a little bit more. I got some grits. I wasn't on the whole milk with it. I was able to get some grits, some Jell-O and some water. You know, I wasn't, at this point, I wasn't able to really hold down a whole lot of food, so that's all I ate. And for lunch, actually, I got a salad. Now, I'm going to tell you what happened before lunch because I was still having these very severe gas pains. And this came from me not passing gas. I wasn't able to pass gas no matter how much I tried. And I wasn't trying to strain myself, but then at the same time, I wanted to pass gas. There's nothing like a good fart in life. Let's get a good fart out. So, I couldn't fart like I wanted to. So, the doctor gave me some milk of magnesia. And I should have actually took that with some food because it came right back up. And I knew it was the milk of magnesia that came back up because I could taste it when it came back up. And it was milk. But then I had me my salad for lunch. And I actually tried to eat a little bit of it so that I could know if I could keep it down or not. But I think it was the medicine that came back up. It wasn't just the food. It was medicine plus everything that I ate the night before, which is very little, but anyway. And for dinner, I had a chicken salad sandwich, which was wonderful. It was the bees. And I actually, throughout that morning, I started walking around 9 o'clock a.m. And I walked actually 5 laps around the floor. Wait, 1 second. I'm back. This is my sweetheart over here hitting on herself. Yeah. But, yeah, let's try to go on and finish up this video. Yeah, hold on 1 second, guys. Okay, so let's see where I leave off. Okay, I was talking about my gas pain. Actually, all of the day after the surgery, I did not pass gas at all, no matter how bad I wanted to. I started walking around 9 that morning. I made 5 laps around the hall that I was on. So I think that was a big accomplishment. And when I first got up to try to walk or whatnot, I could feel the nausea coming on. This was actually before I vomited after the milk of magnesia. I tried to get up and stuff and I felt like I was going to throw up, but it didn't come up. I think it was just the gas pain that was like fluctuating, going, coming, going, coming. So that was that. And yeah, so I made myself get 5 laps in because I'm young, I'm 25, I need to be able to move around. No matter how much I had tried to force myself to do it, I needed to. Because my goal was 4 laps and I wanted to try to be an overachiever and get like 1 extra one. So I did that. And so let's see, what else do I have on here for that day? Okay, the doctor came in and talked about my release and talked about what he found out and all that different stuff around 2:30 p.m. And he initially told us that we would be leaving around 4 or 5, but we didn't leave until like 7:45. Now, the diagnosis that I had was actually endometriosis. No. Endometriosis. Which I'm going to cover in a later video. But, yeah. They had to remove all of that. And they actually found several cysts. It wasn't just one like I originally thought. It was actually several. So, he told me, he diagnosed me with that. That's what he said that I had. And they had to remove it. And he also said that he think that I could possibly be having polycystic ovarian syndrome, which is very scary to me. But I have faith, because this is a good doctor. I have faith that he's actually going to get me what I need, because I want to have a baby one day. I want to have some babies one day. So, and I think he sympathizes with that, because I don't have any children. So he's going to do his best to make sure that my chances of having children actually increases, which is good. So anyway, I was released around 7:45, and I actually came home with Boo Bear, and I went to sleep at around 9, but then I woke up because I was in pain again, so I had to take some pain meds around 10 p.m. Then once I was asleep, I was asleep for the night, and that was all of that day. So the next day, which actually that Friday, still had very severe gas pain. And then we actually packed up the stuff. Well, I didn't pack up, but he packed up, him and my mom and all of them packed up so that I can go to my grandma's house, because he had to actually go to a family reunion for the weekend, which I'm so bummed that I missed it, but I had to do what I had to do. So I went to my grandma's house. Now, some of the symptoms I was still feeling was the gas pain, like I just mentioned, the sore throat, and actually, I noticed just a tad bit of bleeding in my lowest incision, which I'm going to show you the incisions and stuff, but I saw a little bit of bleeding. I panicked, actually, and my grandma helped me. She said, "Child, I ain't nothing to worry about." And then the next day when I woke up, it was actually not bleeding anymore, so my grandma was right. I was panicking for no reason. Now, I am going to tell you an accomplishment that I made on Friday. When I finally got down to my grandma's house, I passed gas at my grandma's house. I think my mom was a little bit jealous. She found out that I passed gas at my grandma's house, and not with her. But anyway. And that was my accomplishment from that Friday. So my gas pain actually went away the next day, which was actually July the 22nd. And I'm going to say it was because I had my first bowel movement since the surgery. My first bowel movement, it was actually like 5:45 or 6 o'clock that morning. And I was so happy to have it. And I actually started eating a little bit more solid foods. Not solid, but a little bit more solid. So I actually had some grits, sausage, and toast for breakfast. Grandma had me spoiled. I love my grandma. And I actually got my hair done too. I know it probably look a little bit ring-a-dinky right now, but my auntie twisted my hair, and it's actually up in the back. And she got it twisted up in the back. For lunch, I ate a little bit of a salad, which is a grilled chicken salad from Zaxby's. And for dinner, I had me some sweet potatoes and the rest of the salad. And that was all from, let me see, this Saturday. Okay, so Sunday is actually the day when I came back home. And for breakfast, I had some grits, sausage, eggs, and toast. Now, I didn't really feel any symptoms at all. I actually was feeling like 60% of myself. And the reason why I was only 60% is because I wasn't moving around as much, but I could. I had the ability to move around if I wanted to. And for lunch and dinner, I had some soup. The 24th, which was actually on yesterday, was when part of my bandage came off. One of my bandages started to come off. And I'm actually seeing the healing process because I'm itching. And I first noticed the itching on Friday or Saturday. It was Friday, because that's when I experienced the bleeding. So I first started itching on that Friday and stuff. So That means I'm healing. And actually, Monday, which was the 24th as well, my mom took me to run errands, and she also got me some chicken tenders for Chick-fil-A. And I was feeling like 75% myself. And today, I actually was lazy today. I didn't do anything. I just slept all day. And I feel like 80% of myself, because I'm still not moving around like I really want to. I can, but I'm not, because I'm being lazy. So hopefully tomorrow will be a little bit better. And that's basically just my rundown of how I've been doing since I didn't do the day-to-day thing like I originally thought I was going to do. Come on here every day and tell you what I've been going through. So since I didn't do that, I just have this one lengthy video. Sorry that it's really lengthy, but I have this one video. And in the next video, I'm actually going to be showing you different pictures and stuff, talking about my diagnosis, how I feel about it, and all of that. So until next time, I'll see you, because I'm actually going to go. And today is the 25th. I'm being lazy today. So I'm going to go and be lazy some more, because I'm sitting up and I really want to lay down. And I'm going to be lazy somewhere and go and sleep. Well, I am drinking a lot of water, which is probably going to help me with my energy and stuff. So I'm going to go lay back down, and I will talk to you later. Bye-bye.